That was on your old computer, right?
Well, no, I'm just saying, like, the server lag, you know, wouldn't have been like.
Oh, yeah.
Map. Like, I don't, nothing. Like, the map doesn't lag my computer at all.
That's good.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Oh, this is taking down my alfalfa. I might have to use.
What's it doing?
I'm running over my alfalfa here with my wheels. I didn't think it was gonna wreck my alfalfa.
Your tire tracks are destroying it.
Yeah. Or maybe this is from a sprayer, I don't know. I was thinking that we could like plant something here and just call it a day on alfalfa, like this should be our last harvest of alfalfa, you know?
Sure. What do you want to throw there, Cord?
I don't know. Maybe put like a older wheat crop here, or...
Yeah.
What else can you run? You wouldn't want to plant beets or anything on this field.
Well, I'd say let's go wheat for 1 week, field a week, and
well, the windrows don't seem to be skipping like they used to, so that's nice. I'm trying to think the last time I used this merger.
Well, how many crops have we taken off that field?
This will be our...
second? Or third?
I think it might be our second.
Because I remember I picked bales there the first time we did it.
And I think that was the first...
That was the first, our first season.
Yeah, this would be our second season. Because I never took any bales off this. I never merged this.
Yeah, no.
You guys were the ones that did it last.
Yeah, Jake mowed it, merged it, and baled it, I think, all in one night.
I did...
Or did you mow it?
I mowed and merged and baled the little 11 section and then north part by 28.
You did that one night when Jake and I were spraying. Ripping, I think.
Yeah, I did like forget what it ended up being, like 70. No, you did 70 bales, I did like 21 bales.
Yeah.
So I think this will be our second crop off this field.
First. Yeah, that's what I thought. I didn't think we did it any other time.
Because what was here before was grass, right?
Yeah, but we never took anything off the grass.
We plowed that under.
Yeah, and then planted alfalfa.
Yeah. So,
cause
it could have been a third crop, but we just didn't even mow the grass. We just just did under. So, what kind of sheds and houses have you been, did you build?
I built them. I think this it could be 2 years old now. I got two house models.
I think houses and buildings are fun to model.
Yeah.
Because it's pretty, it's not as, it's easy because you don't have to separate anything or you don't really have to burn anything. You just UV manual UV map around just simple textures.
I gotta see where I have them, if I've got them in my Dropbox, or if I gotta pull them up from, I don't even know, I might not even have them still, but yeah, I did a hopper bottom bin. The bins aren't anything special, but the hopper bottom is, like I said, the two bins I was learning still. And I've got two shops, two houses, and two different types of grain bins. I'm gonna have to try and track them down where the hell I put them. I'm pretty sure I had them on my Dropbox, but I have to take a look. I can send them to you, see if they're even usable.
I didn't realize you can import SketchUp mods into Blender.
I think I did. I want to say I did, because I think there was a plugin for it.
I've never
Forget.
used it, so I wouldn't know.
Yeah, I forget what kind of plug or what it was called. You had to in. Yeah, but no, yeah, I know the houses I did definitely. I took everything into Blender and then I textured it all in Blender. Actually, I might have built those buildings for 13, to be honest, come to think of it.
I think we're gonna get some pretty decent tonnage out of this. Yeah, I'm missing a lot of.
What's that?
A lot of my alfalfa's gone underneath here, so I don't know what happened. Jay?
Probably. When in doubt, we'll blame Jay. especially
that, that other day, he's like breaking everything in the server.
When he starts going on about that, I love just fueling the fire and saying, well, Jake, why do you break everything? Like, be nice. Wait, he gets...
Jake, you're fired.
Oh, God, I get a kick all of those guys that when you put that one picture up about you spraying, how nobody was showing up for work. Oh, I'll come help you, this and that. It's like, good Lord. It was a joke.
Oh, yeah.
We had a pretty good group, I think. It's fun.
Yeah. I would have thought that FS, like, all the drama would have died down by now, but like the same
people.
It was
quiet there for a while.
It's like new people come out of the woodwork, like all these like new like editors and shit that think they're like gods. They make all these mod pages. Saving the community! It's like,
yeah.
You don't even know how to mod. You're just editing the same fucking truck that's been edited already 800 times. Like,
or you know what they do? They think they're saving the community, like getting into these other groups, getting their mods, starting their own little shitty group.
Yeah, and then they're like, you can't have private mods. It's like, so I release it all.
Yeah.
I don't really like Facebook groups, but it is nice to, like, see, like, other people's hard work.
Yeah.
You know, there's like some really good people out there that know how to like model, and everyone's got different kind of passions. Like, I'm kind of really into big, unique American equipment. You know, people don't really make the same stuff that I make, or they end up making it after I make it, you know, kind of thing. But, you know, that, like, even that Sorensen guy, he made that crazy ass tillage disc. That thing was sweet. You know, I've never seen that before in my life. People are like focusing on like small grain carts, old trucks and old trailers, and making their own maps, and it's fun to see when people are doing not only nice work but unique, like original.
Yeah, it's work. Different, yeah. I like those tandem trucks that one guy made. Those look pretty nice.
What do you mean?
The grain trucks. He's got the tandem axle grain trucks with the dual.
The big grain box on it.
Yeah. Yeah, I like that because it's something similar to what we run.
Yeah, I had a grain truck in 13. Serious Mod sent me his grain box. I like lost all my 13 mods when I updated my motherboard and my CPU. It like corrupted my hard drive. Somehow, I have no idea how, but it happened.
Huh.
Yeah, I'm glad I put in these animations because it works pretty freaking slick to lift up these collectors. I should have probably done the headlamp last. Well, I mean, now I can pick up each individual pickup better. I should be able to avoid messing up the headlamp. So.
I always do the headlamp like three rounds I put into one swath. And
really?
I kind of, the last one, I set it as close to the road as possible. You know, or like one, I forget how the hell I did it, but it seemed to work pretty good. But yeah, I always try and put the headland, you know, merge one, I think it's one or two rounds for sure.
Yeah, I'm doing two.
Like two rounds into one swath?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, I did.
That gives me enough room to turn around and This thing has a pretty tight turning radius because it has the rear steering axle, so.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Well, and. Oh, why is Jake? Jesus Christ, I did it again.
No, 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 you didn't.
Well, Jake, well, I don't know why Jake Spreader's nitrogen looks gray, right? So when I filled, I didn't hit it because it looked gray in the box. I thought I still had the nitrogen.
You put down NPK or what did you put down?
NPK twice. I'm killing you tonight. I'm going to bed. Fuck me.
okay.
I'm fired from the spreader.
He's calling it a night. That was on one? Or what was that?
13, got MPK twice. Jeez.
Ouch.
Well, we were doing everything, so that would damn
well, it
near
doesn't,
work.
Well, it doesn't add anything to the field. It doesn't add anything to the nutrients, you know? If you put down MPK twice in the same, like, gross... It's like you
but
just
you,
wasted, but
like, why does his show up gray?
It's whatever you fill first. Like he probably filled with nitrogen.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm calling there a night. I'm gonna arc.
Yeah, it was only a $3,700 mistake.
Jesus.
All right, so. That means
and I,
you still have to do PK and N.
And yeah. So.
Alright.
Jeez. that was a waste of a half an hour.
Yep. Basically. Alright. See you later then.
Yeah. Good night.
Disconnected.
Well, that sucks. What can you do? if you guys were listening to that. Mike's a little tired, put down an extra thing of MPK on 13. Put it down twice. To come and pick up this little off-road because I merged it in the wrong direction, so that's my bad. That I added individual merger pickup control. Must be these pickup headers that are. Reckon this will help. Also curious what the yield of this alfalfa will be. Not really sure anymore. I upped the yield a little bit compared to grass. The nutrients here is pretty decent. Really sure what we should plant here, to be honest. Might plant this to wheat, just to have some wheat in our bins. And actually looking pretty nice. Usually these windrows don't look this nice because this merger on multiplayer just skips, but seems to be working pretty dang good right now. You know what it might be? I think I have these wings scripted with wheels. That's why it's taking out so much. I'll have to look into it. Doing about 22 meter swaths. We're merging 22 meters worth of material into a single swath, so pretty big. The in-game crone can only get up to 18 meters, so we're getting four. We're covering four more meters. We're putting four more meters worth of material into a swath, so it's a lot more efficient, although it's a little bit smaller. We're covering more ground quicker with this Oxbow 334, which is nice. So then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take this, I'm going to hit 654, and that's going to put the discharge to the right. So I can clean this up a little bit. Then do 654 again. Gotta love it when things work correctly. think they only run these mergers around 5 or 6 miles an hour in real life. You know, when they're merging a big hay crop. If you watch some videos, or if you actually do it in real life, you can see that they're moving a tremendous amount of material. Well, I'm pretty happy, knock on wood, that it's not leaving any streaks of windrow like it was when I was doing this a couple months ago. So that is good news. I don't think they did any updates or anything. Maybe it was the 1.41 patch that did it. I'm not sure. But I don't think it's been doing it since that one point, that latest patch. Could be wrong. It looks nice and neat. This is still the version 2 merger I released to Mod Hoster. Haven't touched it since. But when I first rented it, I saw that there was a little wing issue, so something I could fix with that, and also update the textures on it. The textures are a little bit bad, a little bit of black spots on the bolts and stuff. Stuff like that, and I could script in this front hitch point so it actually moves. At least this rear wheel, I could actually make that move too, probably. Pretty cloudy afternoon today on the map. A little bit of rain, storm clouds over there. Looks pretty nasty. Pretty gloomy up over here, so. Unfortunately, no rain in the forecast. Wish we would get some rain. No rain at all in our 5-day forecast, so. But that again, we only have one hot day, or one sunny day over 22 degrees, so we're not losing too much moisture in our field. This is actually a pretty nice field to farm on, get a nice view up on the hill here, kind of different perspective. I should have done an extra two passes on the headland. It is what it is now. See the big modern dairy farm there across the lake. See the dairy facility's water tower, almost see it. Budweiser, Menards parking lot, houses with the smoke. If you look all the way over there, you can see the smoke going in the houses. I wonder what my FPS is. 40. Maybe we should do more alfalfa on our farm. It's actually a pretty nice change of pace. Get to use our gooseneck trailer on our 3500, get to use our oxbow merger. Get to use a nice big New Holland square baler. Get to use our T8 for something. We used to use this for spraying, but now we have two Patriots in there. We rent the big DNs. So I'm just kind of curious to see what kind of profit we get off this field, if it's even worth, I mean, it's pretty fun to do, it's pretty fun to mow and merge and stuff, but is it financially worth it? Could we do better planting something else here? Looks like our drive control destruction, crop destruction does not like freshly mowed crops. So. I know Decker has wheel lane script. I'm not sure if that's a global script or if you have to enter that individually, so I'll look into that, because I think I was reading on the wheel lane script that it ignores crops up to third growth stage. So if it's third growth stage, three and under, because growth stage one is when you first plant it, two is like really short, three is like medium, then your fourth and fifth are like, pretty sure sixth is your harvest. Something must be up. Drive control.